Hello, my name is Walter, and welcome back to DC's Legends of Tomorrow Season 2, Episode 14, Moonshot. So, maybe they're going to the moon or something. So, I remember in the last episode that they kind of got ripped back, so that's going to be an interesting move going forward. And again, I really want to thank you guys for making My Samurai Jack episode my first 1K viewed, my first 1K viewed video, and I hope to give more insight to you, especially on Samurai Jack, because it's such pride on my end, because I'm kind of the only Asian, Malaysian, Chinese to be doing this type of series. So, anyway, without further ado, let's go. And I guess the reason for that is because I was kind of Americanized as well in a certain way, because I grew up with American media, and I grew up with American TV shows and everything. I grew up with, you know, Hey Arnold. I grew up with Nickelodeon, Disney, and Cartoon Network. So that's just an interesting insight. Anyway, back to DC's Legends of Tomorrow. Yeah, they are just doing the recap and the intro, which today is Mick Rory. Sorry, I'm forgetting the names. And they did talk about Apollo 13 and then the final minutes of the episode last time, so yeah. He went inside. Well, I mean, you know. Not really, don't think so. Oh. Well, I mean, you know, some people believe Elvis is alive. Well, okay. I like this music. I like the score in the background. What intonation? Well, on the moon. Ugh, this whole circling camera thing, oh, it's getting me nauseous. what the fish? What the fuck, sticks? Oh man, Ebert is fucking evil. Nice. But why is he avoiding Rift though? I don't get it. I don't think so. Well, I mean, you know, you could change your past, I mean, your future, but well, I don't think Rip is in charge anymore. Hard to stop someone flying in space, am I right? Okay. Nice. Fight, 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 fight. Shit. So, like, Adam is the combination of Iron Man and Ant-Man, because this is practically Ant-Man's Iron Man suit as well as Ant-Man suit, because it can shrink, so that's really good. And plus you know, Raymond is a billionaire. Wait, Raymond's on the moon. Daylight, come and we wanna go home. Ayo, nego. Nah. Well, yeah, that's true. Puns. Well, humor is still humor. Whew, sorry. It's getting a bit tired. He's becoming a Barry Allen. Most probably. That must be hard, man. Look at that, though. That's actually impressive. Okay, let's not talk about this and argue about this. Okay, just, oh, fish sticks and apple pies. Oh. Well, that was a bust. Dun, dun. Nice Space Odyssey. Dun, 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 dun. Dun. Dun 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 dun. nice. And now I know how my demon felt. Okay, this is an homage to Martian and all of those movies, Interstellar, Well, I mean, Ebert is a scientist too. Yeah, that's true. I mean, you gotta figure it out somehow. She does, and you are right. I told you guys, he's becoming a Barry Allen. I think she would. That's true. A handshake. It's Sarah. Yes, scientists obsess about playing God, essentially. That's true. Not in this time. Nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Nice. Nice. Pray. Pray for them. Steely-eyed missile man. Apollo 13 was supposed to blow up, right? We might be stuck here. Well, it's always, you know, one choice or the other. Fair enough, you know? But I know this hits. Yeah, that's true. Physics. I don't think you have a choice, Ray. But we don't have a choice. You don't have a guy. You guys don't have a choice. Rip. He has to, yeah, he has to. Let's go. Let's go. This episode, man, is all about trust and I think I kind of know like where he's going with this, because he's probably gonna That's true. I'm so sorry, bro. I'm sorry, Nathaniel. So sad, man. That's so sad, though. I mean, I really get where Nathaniel's coming from. See, I knew it. I knew it. It's quite a good episode, I must say. Well, that's true. Drink that brandy whiskey, bro. Indeed. Well, you know. Yep, it does. Nice. No. Yeah. Oh, that is so cheesy, bro. And the best of all is, oh no, he didn't use that line. Damn it, I thought he was gonna say the best of ways. Yep, she saw her future. And the end is just Stein and Mick singing. Yeah, but nah. Come and me wanna go home. But touch. Nice voice, Professor. Yeah, guys, that was about it. Nothing really much happened, but as I said, I think I knew where it was going, but it kind of had a twist because the Speed Force was coming after him, which is essentially Zoom, who died and became one of the Time Wraiths, protectors of the Speed Force kind of thing. So that was about it, and I will see you, Samurai Jack. See you then. Bye.